In this video, we're going to learn how to magically stretch your photos using the various features of the Content Aware Scale. Today, I'm going to share with you some of the most fantastic tips, tricks, techniques, and hacks to fool Photoshop and get your images fit any size. So without any further ado, let's get started. So here we are in Photoshop, and by the way, do make sure to download all the images shown in the tutorial so that you, my friend, can follow along. So in the first image, as you can see, suppose you want to make a Facebook cover out of this. So there are two options. Of course, you can crop it from the bottom, crop it from the end, and you can make it. But you don't want to crop it. You want the whole of the wall, the whole of the surface. You want it all. Here's what you need to do. You need to stretch it. So first, let's go ahead and stretch the canvas, make the canvas in the ratio of the Facebook cover. So what is the ratio of the Facebook cover? 851 by 315. So press C first and then change the values here. 851, just so you know, 315. There we go. This is the ratio. Now let's make it bigger till it fits. There you go. It snaps right in there. If it doesn't snap, make sure you go to View and make sure Snap is checked. Okay. So once the canvas is right, hit Enter. Now, the normal way of stretching this would be Controller Command T and stretching it like this. But the problem here is the vase and the flowers also get stretched. What to do now? There's an awesome tool in Photoshop called the Content Aware Scale. Let me show that to you. So let's go back. And if you go to Edit, Content Aware Scale, and now if you stretch it, watch what happens. Wow! Isn't that wonderful? Here's what's happening. Hit Enter. Now you can add text here, you can move it here and there, you can stretch it even more if you want to crop it from the sides, if you want to keep it on the right hand side, and you get the idea. The Content Aware Scale stretches anything that is seamless. For example, in this case, it was the wall. The wall is seamless, some of the floor is seamless. See, it didn't stretch the tiny little signs here, little symbols here. It just didn't stretch that. But it stretched the table. It did, right? It stretches anything which is seamless. Anything which is sharp, anything which has a certain dimension to it, just like the flower vase and the flowers, it doesn't stretch it. So that's how it works. Let me show you another example. But before I show you that example, some of you might ask, is there some exceptions? Of course there is, and we're going to discuss that later in the tutorial. Okay, so if you move into this one, the same crop tool is selected if you stretch it like that. Okay, hit Enter. Now, if you go to Edit, Content Aware Scale, and if you make it bigger, it just doesn't stretch the man. But after a certain point, this is fine, but after a certain point, as you can see, his coat is getting stretched. How to solve it? Well, that's what this video is all about. So let me illustrate this using this example, because you might see more problems here. So, go to Edit, Content Aware Scale. Also, you can remember the shortcut. Shortcut is Alt, Shift, Control, C. In Mac, it would be Option, Shift, Command, and C. Okay, so press Alt, Control, Shift, C. Now, stretch it. Up to this way, it's fine. But as you can see, her shoulders are getting stretched here. We don't want that. Here's what to do. Okay, hit Enter. Let's go back. To go back, Control, Alt, Z. Command, Option, Z if you're using a Mac. Okay, now, it's very easy. Take the lasso tool or any selection tool that you desire and roughly just outline the subject, just like this. Just roughly do it. Okay. Leave a little space there. There we go, just like that. Now, go to the channels. Click on this mask button. This creates a new alpha channel. Now press Ctrl or Command D to deselect that. Make sure RGB red, green and blue is selected, and it's already selected. Come back to layers. Now, when you press Ctrl, Alt, Shift and C, Command, Option, Shift and C, and then, here's a little text at the top which is usually hidden and people don't notice it. Protect and choose Alpha 1. What it does is that it protects the selection that we made. Now when you stretch it, have a look. Isn't that wonderful? But it also has a limitation, but you can stretch more. Isn't that interesting? Now some of you might ask how to stretch it even more. Now here's how to fool Photoshop. Once you're done with stretching to the point where it looks okay, hit Enter. Okay, hit Enter. Again, make a selection if you want. Again, make a selection of her. Just a loose selection. Just like that. And then go to channels, click on another mask. This is alpha 2. Controller command D. Now, let's zoom out just a little bit. Again, go to Control Alt Shift C, and this time protect alpha 2 and even more. Isn't that interesting? Now here's the thing. Before it was stretched, there was a little difference between the blurred area and the sharp area. Now once it is stretched, the difference increases. Here's how we fool Photoshop. The difference between blurred area and the sharp area increases because you have already stretched the blurred area. It becomes more blurred. So the next time when you go, Photoshop again stretches that already stretched area. Now let me give you one another tip regarding this, okay? So as you can see, if you wanted to write something here, this is okay. This is stretched little, this is stretched more. Why? Because we dragged it from the right hand side. But if you want her to be in the center, very simple, let's go back again, okay? And place her in the center, as simple as that. Place her in the center and then go Ctrl-Alt-Shift-C and then oops, it's a smart object now. Let's rasterize that. We went a little too back. Control Alt Shift C and stretch it from the right and stretch it from the left equally. Also, there's another way of doing this. Press and hold Shift and Alt. Shift an option if you're using a Mac, then stretch it from the right. It stretches like this, equally from the left and right. Again, you might have to select it and create an alpha channel for this not to be stretched and looking strange, just like a deformity or something. So you have the idea, right? Let me illustrate one other example where we can easily fool Photoshop. In this example, as you can see, we don't really have much background to stretch. It's very less background. And if you try Ctrl-Alt-Shift-C, Command-Option-Shift-C, if you're using a Mac, try to stretch it, this is fine. And after this, she starts to get fatter. Here's what to do, okay? Don't stretch it too much. Stretch it just a little bit, up to the point where she begins to stretch, okay? This is okay, this point is fine, okay? Hit enter. No alpha channel, nothing. And again stretch. See? She's not getting fatter. Stop at the point where she starts getting fatter. This point, hit enter. Again, Ctrl-Alt-Shift-C. So when you do this step by step, usually you fool Photoshop because the difference between the blurred area and the sharp area, the area with dimension and the seamless area increases, right? Because it's already stretched. Now when you stretch it again, of course, the background gives such a nice effect, but you basically have the idea of how to fool Photoshop with this, okay? Now you have stretched such, okay, this is getting fatter, hit enter again. And again, go to Ctrl-Alt-Shift-C and again, make it more stretched. Of course, you can also use alpha channel in this for much better results. And that pretty much wraps it up. By the way, the content-aware scale has one more feature which I really didn't want to talk about because it's very kind of doesn't work. But let me just show that to you. If you go to Ctrl-Alt-Shift-C content-aware scale again, there's a tiny human being icon here. And if you click that, it will protect what? The skin tones, right? If you click that, it says that it won't stretch human beings, that's what it shows, but it does a very bad job of it. Have a look. It doesn't stretch skin tones, but it's very bad. If you want a certain kind of effect, that's okay. It's not stretching a face, but it's stretching everything else, which is very useless. Okay. So that pretty much wraps up the content-aware scale. You can not only use it to get your images fit any size, but also use it creatively. As you saw in the last example, we overstretched the background to give it a really nice stretched effect, right? Also, here's just a quick reminder. Number one, the content-aware scale stretches anything which is seamless. Number two, if you want to stretch extra, and if stretching extra distorts your subject, create an alpha channel. Number three, another trick to get around this problem is this. Stretch it to the point where the subject starts distorting. Hit enter. Again, go to the content-aware scale, stretch it even more to the point where the subject starts distorting. Hit enter. And that's how you fool Photoshop and exceed the limits. I hope this video helped you, and if it did, make sure to give us a like, and also don't forget to subscribe, and not just subscribe. Ring the bell so that you, my friends, don't miss any other future single episode or something. I'll see you guys in my next one. Until then, stay tuned and make sure that you keep creating.